fallen god, creator and destroyer of worlds, hear my vow. Hear my vow. My vow of defiance.
The monastery's ahead. I wonder if it is still safe.
Either way, our quest for Antanas nears a conclusion.
I hope he's worth all the men we've lost on our way here.
We made it. Let's get to work. It's quiet. Too quiet. Even for a monastery. Hold on.
It's locked.
You're still losing blood, Caslo. The Rogar got you good.
I didn't let you out of prison to worry about me.
You're no use to me if you bleed to death.
I will try to spare you the inconvenience of my death.
The man we're looking for. How will we find him?
He's the leader of all humanity. If we find his guards, we'll find him.
So far, I've seen only corpses, no survivors.
The Rogar have clearly breached the walls of the monastery. Antanas would have given his life to protect his people. If he is alive, then some of them might have survived too.
There must be some way to open this door.
A switch, perhaps, or a key.
These things keep coming. We fight back, but there are too many of them. It is sickening to see them move. Their limbs twist and turn in ways they're not supposed to. And their smell. It's like fire and death creeping up your nose. One of the creatures we were fighting spat on us. The saliva hit my eye. It burned, and it burns deeper into me.
We need to find a way to get to the other side.
Thank you.
It is in me, and it is changing me, my skull. The bones are moving, growing. It does not feel like poison in my veins, more like liquid darkness. We have seen with others what happens next. Eyesight goes first, then follows sanity. Brother William, Brother Peter and I won't let the disease take us. We will choose death before it chooses us.
Dear Father, the fires on the horizon, they are spreading towards our village. I beg you, be careful. Something evil is happening. I can feel that. You can always seek refuge here, in the monastery.
Whatever happens, Antanas can save us. Please,
please, be safe.
Thank you.
found a key. What are you waiting for? Open the door. I could use some help. Here, this might be useful. One of those lords Caslow keeps talking about.
It is in me, and it is changing me. My skull. The bones are moving, growing. It does not feel like poison in my veins, more like liquid darkness. We have seen with others what happens next. Eyesight goes first, then follows sanity. Brother William, Brother Peter and I won't let the disease take us. We will choose death before it chooses us.
Soon after banishing the god, the three men that were known as the Judges parted ways forever. Apart from their common goal, they were very different in every possible way. Three statues were built for them on the square of the Judges, displaying the distinct paths they had taken. These statues hold a secret as if it were their heart, but it is retained by the stone. Only the Shard of Heroes could make that heartbeat. And only an unearthly force could tear it out.
What exactly were the Lords? They wielded power beyond our understanding. They fought fiercely and they blindly followed the God. Anyone who tried to talk to them, reason with them, failed. The Lords did not come for discussion. They came to serve their purpose. To lead the Rogar army against the humans.